Several students and a parent are accused of attacking a student inside a classroom at Southern Guilford High School. Fort Hatchett is live outside the school with details for us. Fort?
Yeah, absolutely. It's really just a mind-blowing story here that an adult, someone almost 40 years old, was part of a group of 8 people who charged into Southern Guilford High School here Tuesday morning to beat up a 14-year-old. Now, we still don't really know what the motivation behind it was, but it's raising a lot of questions about the safety and security of students inside. Let's start with what we do know. It was Monday that 2 students got into an altercation at a bus stop. We don't know what it was about, but one of the girls that was involved in that incident began to organize a group to retaliate the next morning. She gathered 2 other students from Southern Guilford High and 3 other students from different schools in the districts, in addition to an 18-year-old who was not a student. And perhaps most shocking is one of the group's mother, a 37-year-old woman, joined the assault. Now, the school resource officers and principal on hand were able to shut this down fairly quickly, and the school was never put on lockdown. A Guilford County Schools representative telling me everything happened so quickly that by the time that they could have issued a lockdown, the incident was already under control. One parent we spoke with today says her son was in the building as this was going on, and she only learned of this incident a full day later when a letter and voicemail was sent out to parents. Now, normally the doors to the school are locked to the outside public, but this group was let inside by students at Southern Guilford. Brian Hall is the Guilford County Sheriff's School Resource Officer Captain and says that all protocols were followed.
It's an unfortunate reality of a school building like that, that there are so many doors. They do a great job keeping them all locked. Our SROs go around and double check behind them to make sure they are. But, you know, short of chaining those doors shut from the inside, there's very little in place to stop a student from opening a door for someone on the outside, unless you had someone posted at every door every day.
And Captain Hall says the victim involved suffered minor injuries to her face, and he expects the juveniles to be charged in this crime. And the 2 adults, he expects warrants for their arrest to be out later this afternoon on charges of assault, trespassing, and inciting a riot. In Greensboro, Fort Hatchett, WXII 12 News.